Good morning, children. Today we'll see history, the part 2 of Sources of Medieval India. In the last part, we spoke about all the monuments in India which depict the medieval India. Today, we are going to look about the coins first. The picture and the legend on the coins convey the name of kings with their titles and portraits, events, places, dates, dynasties, and logos. The composition of metal in the coin gives us information on the economic condition of the empire. Muhammad Ghori had stamped the figure of Goddess Lakshmi on his gold coins and had his name inscribed on it. Copper jitas are available for the study of the period of the Delhi Sultans. Jitas contain 3.6 grains of silver. 48 jitas were equal to 1 silver tanka. Silver tanka were introduced by Iltutmish. Alauddin Khilji's gold coins, Muhammad bin Tughlaq's copper token currency are indicative of coinage as well as the economic prosperity. Religious literature. Devotional movement in South India and later in North India resulted in the development of bhakti or devotional literature. The Chola period was known as the period of devotional literature, and works such as Kamba Ramayanam by Kambar, Shekilar's Periya Puranam, Nalayara Divya Prabandham composed by 12 Alvars and compiled by Nadamuni, Devaram composed by Appar, Sammandar and Sundarar and compiled by Nambiyandar Nambi, Manikavasagar's Thiruvasagam, all were scripted during the Chola times. Jayadeva's Gita Govindam of the 12th century was a follow-up of the Bhakti movement in South India. Kabir Das, a 15th century mystic poet, also had an influence on the Bhakti movement in India. Secular literature. Madhura Vijayam composed by Ganga Devi and Amyukta Malyata by Krishnadeva Raya helps us gain insight of the Vijayanagar Empire. Chand Bardai's Prithiviraj Raso portrays the Rajput king's valor. We have no Indian accounts about what happened during the Turkish invasion of India. For pre-Islamic periods, the only exception was Kalhana's Rajtarangini